So today's tutorial, what I want to show you now is how to cut your jumpsuit. And this jumpsuit which I want to make now will have collar on it. So I want to give you or show you rather on how to cut it. So let's go straight to the cutting. What I have is my fabric unfold. This is the right side and this is the wrong side of my fabric. So I fold, place it on fold by right side, facing right side. And this is the wrong side which we are going to mark with our shirt. So what we are going to do first of all, because I want to cut out the front, and what we will do now is to cut out, take your bust measurement divided by 4 plus 5 inches or 4.5. So what I want to do now is my bust measurement divided by 4 plus 4.5. And that's what measurement gives me 15.2. So that is the 15.2 which I'm going to get here. 15.2. Let me make it 15.5 in total. 15.5. Okay. So for the length of our jumpsuit is 19. For the half length. Yeah, our half length is 19. But first of all, I take off our English line which we have here, some written words on it, so I'm going to take that off, terminate it total, and what I'll do now is to get my 19.5. so this is my 19.5 which I have here, plus 1 inch for sewing allowance gives me 20.5. So that is a 20.5 I'm going to take here. Remember, my measurement is 19.5 plus my 1 inch for sewing allowance gives me 20.5. So what I'm going to do now is to connect my 20.5 down here, down to the other part, and I'm going to cut it out. So after it is being cut out, I'll keep it this extra outside. I'll cut it back later, but use the front to cut our back. So what I will do for my front now is to mark out my overlap for the front. It will have zip at the back and the front will also have overlap. So that's my overlap now. I want to take away 1.2 inches because I'm going to use lining to fold it. For this overlap, if you are using, if you are not going to use lining, you need more than this because of your folding inside. I'm going to show you one key point which I normally use, and it relaxes well for my front. So I'm going to show you that formula and explain how you make it when you don't want to use lining on it. But in this case, I want to use lining, so I'm using 1.2 inches for my front. So at this front, I'm going to mark 1.2 inches downward. So connect my 1.2 like this. So after connecting my 1.2, let me get my bust measurement, which is 43. My bust measurement divided by 4. You know how to do it. For beginners, you can just take your tape into 4. That is into 2, and this is into 4. So what you'll do next is to place it here. This is what I have for my, after dividing it into 4 plus 2 inches, then come down to the waist and calculate. My waist is 39 divided by 4. Still going to do the same thing, 39 divided by 4. Gives me 9.5, 10.5 plus sewing allowance 2 inches, plus my dart allowance, because I input darts in this center and put it back. That allowance is 1, which is 3 in total. So all I'm going to do now is to connect it down here like this. Okay, connect it down there like this. Just giving you an instance of how it will look, because after joining here, this will fall in place to complete it like that. So go next to our shoulder measurement, and my shoulder is finished. So take my shoulder measurement, and my shoulder measurement for this is 17, which gives me 8.5. This is the 8.5 which I'm going to put here, 17 for my shoulder measurement, plus half inch for sewing allowance, plus half inch for sewing allowance at the shoulder. So what I'm going to do now is to connect my shoulder to my armhole here. So what I do now is to connect it like this down to my, so on how to get your armhole as we come to it. So how to get your armhole is your bust measurement, sorry, your armhole measurement divided by 2. My armhole is 20 divided by 2 gives me 10. So which is the 10 I'm going to use here. Okay, this is the armhole here. So what I have here now, I bring it back here. So this is my armhole here, 12.2. So I connect my armhole. This is my armhole which I have here now. So for this part, to get your shoulder slant, you come down by 2 inches. Come down by 2 inches for your shoulder slant, and you connect down to this edge up here, just like this. Connect down to this end. And what you do next is to get your midpoint from this, your slanted line, to your armhole. What I have here now is 8 divided by 2. My midpoint gives me 4. And at this 4 position there now, I'm going to come in by 1 inch. Come by 1 inch. If you have your French curve, this will help you a lot. You connect from here to this point, and from this point to this, your armhole point. So to get my curve now, I come in like this. So you go ahead and use your French curve. I'm using freehand for those that do not have French curve to be able to do it with your freehand. So use your freehand for this to connect. So what I'm going to do now is to cut it out. Okay, after getting your measurement now, we are going to get our neck circumference. So my neck circumference which I have is 16 divided by 6. 16 divided by 6 gives me 2.6. So what I'm going to put here now is 2.6 for my neck measurement for the width. So this is 2.6 now, but you know, when sewing, you're not going to cut exactly this 2.6 because you are still going to sew in your collar. So what you are going to do now is to minus 0.3 inches. So this is my 0.3 which I took out. Here you can see 0.3. So how to get your down measurements from your neck depth? Since we have 2.6 here, we are going to plus 0.5, which gives us 2.6 plus 0.5 gives us 3.1. So this 3.1 now, as I told you for here, you're not going to use exactly 3.5. I'm going to minus 0.3. So let's count 1, 2, 3. This is what we're going to take here, because we're going to put our collar. This is what we're going to take there and come down here. Like this. And at this position here now, we are going to come in by 0.5 to get our curve for our neck shape, just like this. So to do now is to cut out. So after we have cut out this for our front, what we are going to do now to come at this down part to impute our nipple to nipple measurement. That is what we are going to cut out for our dart at this down part now. So this is our mark for our dart. And our shoulder to bust for this person is 11. This is 11. So from this 11, from your shoulder to bust measurement, you come down by 2. And this is where your dart leg is going to end for your bust. So it is where it is going to end, just like this. So let me give it a notch as an indication for that. Okay. Here now is the back. As you can see, I've gotten my back and I place my front on my back. And what you are supposed to have for your back is your zipper allowance, because I told you it will have zipper at the back. So this 2 inches is for the zipper allowance at our back. So what we are going to do next now is to fold in this your 2 inches allowance at the back for the zip, and you pin down. So I will go ahead and fold it and pin it down and come back to show you how it looks. Here I've gone ahead to fold my 2 inches allowance, which I have here. As I told you, 2 inches which I have here, I have folded it in for my zipper allowance. And this is my front, which I have here. So this is where I come, where I want to show you now, that is very, very important. So when cutting your front and your back, you don't make it equal. It is wrong for you to make it equal like this. You should have allowance. That is why I brought out this. So this is my 1/2 inch allowance here. This is my 1/2 inch allowance which I have here. Because when sewing, what I will do is to this is my center line. So once you have your center line here, if you want to cut out both for shirt, when placing it, because after you have folded this in for shirt, you don't place it like this. If you place it like this, it won't balance at the front. The front will be smaller than the back, because after it has overlapped, it will have some excess that it has you have put in inside, so it will not be comfortable. So what we'll do now is to have your overlap, which contain that half now outside. So what I have here now is my sewing allowance, because after sewing, I'm going to top stitch and trim. After top stitching now, I might use even half that from here. So you're just using here to give you a guide. So what you will do for this overlap, which you know you have for chest, if you make it like this, it is wrong. But if you make yours like this, then you cut from here, because once you overlap, I'm going to show you when I come to that thing. I'm just letting you know that, okay, it's like I will make a video on shirts, even if it's on pattern paper, to show you how to go about this. But make sure you don't make it equal. Make sure you have an extra half for your overlap, because once your buttons sit here, your buttons is going to sit here. It won't sit here, because after you have overlapped your front like this, if you make it like this now, 1/2 inch will fall on it like this. So it will make your front to be smaller than the back. It's supposed to be equal. So when you use this part now, as your overlap, it will balance, because after this part now has gone inside, when I'm done cutting, I will show you how it should look like. So what you are going to do next, let me go straight to what I'm doing. So what you're going to do next is, for this your shoulder line here now, you know we came down by 2 inches for our shoulder slope. For this up now, we are going to put 2.5 at this up. We are increasing it by 1/2. And here, we are going to use the same 2 inches which I put in place for there. So what you are going to do next now is to take, is to roll it out. So roll it out like this. So for your neck now, you bring this up. For your neck now, what you're going to get for your neck depth for the back, 1.5. It's 1.5. So you curve it like this. Don't make sure you don't make it straight. Give it a curve like this for your back. And for this, you connect it like this. Let me go ahead and cut. Okay, so after you have cut out, now what you do now is to place it like this. So after you've placed it like this, you can see for this front now, there's an SS coming out here for the front. So what you do now is to connect it with your chalk to lap your neck shape like this. This one here is intruding. Let me trim this out. Okay, so as I told you now, you can see after placing your shoulder like this, you can see this one now is intruding. If you go ahead to sew it like this, it will not match. So what you will do, as I told you, is to curve out your neck shape here. Draw your chalk from this where this one stops now. Take it like this. So that's what I'm going to cut out now. Okay, so that is that for the back in the front, as you can see. So what I will do now, go ahead to put my lining, because I told you I'm going to lining the both of them. So I'm going to divide this. So for this point now, I told you I will be using 1/2 inch for my sewing allowance. So that's what I'm going to cut out for this. Okay, I will be using, so I will go ahead to cut both the front. This is the back and this is the front. So I'll go ahead and cut it to and come back and show you what to do next. So I have cut out my lining and I want to show you some work you need to do for this front lining now. So I've also gone ahead to cut my back lining. So for this front, what I will do for this front now, because I want to put my Ankara fabric at this front here now. So what I will do is to take 4 inches like this. You can take 3.5, you can take 4, it depends on you, on how you want it, how wide you want it to be. Because this part now, I'm going to put Ankara on it. So I'm going to cut out. Okay, I still want to clarify you on this front, because I don't, since it is not a complete shirt, I know it will be difficult for you to understand. I want to show you something, still throw more light on this note. So I'm taking my exact bust measurement here. This is my exact center front measurement. So this is my exact center front measurement, and this is the half inch I told you should have excess when it comes to your front. So let's say this is your center. If you cut this, make this your center front. Let me mark it with chalk, or let me use my pin rather to pin it, because I want to explain something. Let me see if this explanation might help. Let me still throw more light on this. So I'll go ahead and pin this and pin both for the other side for it, and I'll come back to show you what I'm saying. So as I told you, I want to throw more light on that front where many people are making mistakes, and I would like to do some recap on it to correct it. So as I told you, this is my zipper allowance. If it were to be a main shirt, there will be no zip, only this front opening. But because I will seal this back and your front button will end here, it will not be able for the person to wear the jumpsuit if it does not extend down to the down pants. So that's why I'm putting this back, because my zip is going to start from the down pants up to this level from my back, so the person will be able to wear it. But I want to throw more light on this button issue. But this button issue is one problem which I was also corrected by a friend, and I would like to share it with you. So let me just say, this is how you cut your shirt. Both your front and your back is equal, and you go ahead and cut it out like this. This is your center front, this is your center front closed, and your back equal. Okay, if you now want to put your button, because you have folded that extra inch which I told you. So if you now go ahead to put your button, you know it will sit like this. It will, if it sits like this, believe me, it has shorten, because it is supposed to sit like this. Because you use here, to get your exact measurements for this part. I don't know if you get what I'm trying to say, because you use there to get your exact measurement for this part. So you can see. So if you go ahead to climb it, because you want to put your zip allowance, it is now short. So you need that extra half. You need that extra half which I have, which I put there. Because you know there's an extra half at this other, okay, this other side here is an extra half that will do the climbing for you, that will do this overlapping for you. So this is my extra half now, comes out, and you place it like this, because I notched my center line. So if you place it like this and you sew out your half for your sewing out like this now, and this one climbs here now, you can make here your button line, where your button will sit, at this your center front. I don't think if you get what I'm trying to say. So if you do it like this, this is, it has balance, but in the sense that you leave this in without putting that your extra half inch and climb like this, it will short, because you took your measurement, your calculation, you calculated it like this, and this calculation here is exactly both the front and the back exactly measurement. But if you now take this in, because you want to get your button measurement, there's an error there. So you have to try your best to correct this error. I just think I should share this before cutting it, because I don't know when I might cut shirt for you to understand, but before then you should get some clue on understanding how to cut this. So this is this for the for what I want to show you. And for your back too, you're also going to put your dart allowance. You're also going to put your dart at the back, because this person's a female. So the bust. So you need to put your allowance at the back here. And from here you come up down to this your What do I have here? 11. Your 11 here. So this is this, and that is that. So that is what I want to show you. I hope you just give it a try. Just give it a try. There's no harm in trying. Just give it a try to understand what I'm trying to show you. So this is my dart for the back. So I'm going ahead to cut the pants. You just keep washing. Let me go ahead to cut the pants.